Hey everybody, coming to you from Gateway Classic Cars over here outside of St. Louis, Missouri.
And today I thought you might like a look at this 1948 Desoto four-door sedan. And obviously they've made a bit of a hot rod out of this one, but it's definitely looking tough. We'll take a look at it here. You can see these Desotos had a pretty imposing grille up front and a nice big chrome bumper. And it has a real impressive hood ornament, as you can see. And this one's in kind of a satin black. You can see it has a little bit of a sheen to it. Very nice. And I like the wheels they've chosen here. It's got the steel wheels with some wide whites. And it has those kind of bullet style centers. But it definitely gives it a tough look. They've also added the big visor above the windshield. It has a divided windshield, as you can see. And they've tinted all the windows on the car. Nice little sort of swan neck style mirrors. And these have the suicide doors in the rear. And in fact, I'll go ahead and open up both sets of doors. That'll give us a little more light in there so we'll look around. You can see how those rear doors are rear hinged. But opens up nice and wide, so you have nice access there. And it has a full custom interior. Nice two-tone. Nice comfortable set of bucket seats up front. And they have the seat belts integrated into them. That is a power seat. You have the controls right here on the left side there. And it has a later model column in it as well with tilt. Nice three-spoke wheel. That's a leather-wrapped wheel. And all custom gauges as well. You have a 140 mile per hour speedometer there and a little mini tach integrated into the same gauge there. And then a multi-gauge to the right. And since this has a visor on it, it has this little prism on the dash, and that's so you can actually still see the stoplights when you pull up to them. It'll reflect in here where you can see it. It's pretty cool. A lot of chrome on this dash as well. It says Desoto right there across the dash. And it's definitely looking impressive. And you got your AC controls right here as well. And a more modern stereo. I mean, it looks like a nice, comfortable car. They've added some cup holders down here, and it does have power windows. They're right here in the console. So it's been updated quite a bit. Nice, comfortable seat in the back as well. I mean, that thing looks like a couch, basically. Very impressive. That door shuts nice. I mean, it's a nice straight car too. And this is your fuel filler here. It's got the kind where it pops open there. Nice clean look to it though. Nice big chrome rear bumper as well. And that says Desoto in it. And as you can see, it has dual exhaust with chrome oval tips. And I don't know if we can see it here, but it actually has an 8.8 inch forward rear end with limited slip. Nice durable rear end. But like I said, just a nice straight car all the way around. And up front here, it's actually got a Mustang II style front suspension. And yeah, it's pretty much the go-to thing for these hot rods, that's for sure. Let me go ahead and pop open the hood and we'll take a look under there. Alright, as you can see, it's nicely detailed under the hood as well. It's actually powered by a 305 Chevy small block, but it's been dressed up really nicely. Nice thinned aluminum air cleaner up top and some matching valve covers. And as you can see, it's a later model centerbolt style engine. Got your AC compressor up here as well. And a nice polished alternator. And I noticed they did add some tubular headers, nice coated headers. And billet pulleys. I mean, it's really looking sharp under here. It even has a polished intake. with an Edelbrock 4-barrel carb. Very nice. And this is backed up by a 700R4 automatic, so it does have overdrive. So I mean, it'd be a nice cruiser for sure. I mean, it's definitely a well-built car. Let's go ahead and check out the specs on it. Once again, it's a 1948 DeSoto 4-door sedan. 11,000 miles since they completed the restoration and build. And they have a lot of information on it here. You can, you know, pause and read all the details. But like I said, that's a Fat Man Mustang II front end. They did put a Walker radiator in it. And all new glass, except for the rear window. Definitely an attention grabber. I mean, it has a tough look to it for sure.
Well, anyway, guys, hopefully you found that one interesting. I'm going to keep looking around and see what else they have. I appreciate you watching and commenting and everything, and I'll see you later. Bye.